Guys, it's almost here. Shark Week starts tomorrow. And to hold you over, we've got an amazing episode of The Daily Bite. There's something we gotta talk about, okay? Gotta clear the air. Someone used my private bathroom. Ha ha! I don't know who it was, someone in the crew, or someone in the audience, but gosh.
We're just one day away from Shark Week. I'll be free soon, and we can clean 3 weeks of trash out of this booth. On today's show, we'll check out our top sharks, some pregnant sharks, and hit the streets of New York to hear what you think of Shark Week. It's Shark Week Eve, and this is The Daily Bite. Okay, now it's time for my foot massage.
I love counting. Sometimes I just like to sit, stare, and count. That's why I'm really excited about this next segment. It's the top sharks of Shark Week. Take a look in 5, 4, 3, 2, now!
Chuggy is a male great white about 16 feet long that has an identifying cut on the upper part of his tail. Marcio has seen him at the island every year since 2006 and has been tracking his movements. Chuggy, like most great white sharks around the world, has been patrolling shallow water. One female towers over the rest, a massive 18-foot monster. Michael has run into her before. He calls her Gill Rakers. Open wounds suggest that she's recently mated. The male bites her to hold her in position.
Most things about everything. I know all about race cars and comedy and electromagnetic engineering. Just to name a few. But what I don't know is all about shark sex. Let's learn that together in this next segment called Shark Sex 101. Whew, put the O in that.
All right, here we are at the Frying Pan, New York City. And while these people are putting food in their bellies, we're gonna talk about sharks putting babies in theirs. Today's lesson is about shark pregnancy. This is Shark Sex 101. Okay, the pregnancy test comes back positive. Now what? Well, it depends which type of shark you are. If you're a spiny dogfish shark, you're gonna be pregnant for about 2 years. If you're a basking shark, you can plan on holding on to that baby for about 3. Now, if you're a frilled shark, you're gonna be pregnant for 42 long months. Damn, that's crazy. I still can't believe my own mom had to carry me for 9 months. I don't think she'd ever forgive me if she was stuck with my big ass for 3.5 years. My back hurts just thinking about that. This is why some species, the brown-banded bamboo shark, for example, chooses to store the semen until the time is just right. In fact, they can put off fertilization for up to a couple years. Hey, not everyone's ready to become a mother right away, and that's okay. This is kind of like freezing your eggs. I mean, sometimes you have a career and goals, and then when the time is right and you're done enjoying everything in life, then you're ready for motherhood. Sharks have goals too, you know. Let's say you're a pregnant great white. The baddest shark in all the ocean is about to become a mommy. But don't go thinking she's gonna be raising some softies, because inside her womb is a literal fight to the death. Great white shark pups feed off the unfertilized eggs left behind as their source of nutrition to grow and develop. A process known as oophagy. Oo meaning egg and phagy meaning to eat. Essentially means they're egg eaters. And what happens when the eggs run out? Well, these little egg eaters begin to eat each other, and only one can survive. If that's not badass, I don't know what is. And you thought you and your siblings fought. Let's not forget to give the mom some props too. She's basically swimming around with some straight up Lord the Fly going on in her belly. That takes some guts. Sand tiger shark pups also do this. I guess when you have the eye of the tiger, nothing is gonna stop you from reaching your goal. Not even your unborn brother's embryo. Not all sharks are trying to kill their brothers and sisters from day one. I mean, not all babies are born with that kind of attitude. And that will take us to our next lesson, where we talk about shark birth. Talk about birth. Until then, I'm the captain. Class dismissed.
Now, it goes without saying that Shark Week has some of the greatest fans in the world. That's why we're taking to the streets to find out what it is that you guys love about Shark Week. It's I Heart Shark Week. Take a look. Enjoy.
Thanks, Jordan. It's me, Tim Mahoney, the least famous person ever to be on camera, and I'm here in New York City to ask people what they love about Shark Week. I'm gonna have a blast.
What does the phrase, live every week like it's Shark Week, mean to you?
I think it's just being aware of the marine environment and what we can do as a people to conserve.
Guys, yeah.
That means live on the edge. Don't take any moment for granted, and just keep swimming.
Jump out of the water, eat some seals.
Survive, no matter what the odds, get out there and survive, and every day's a new day.
Stealth around, bite a couple people, and go through the city like that. I don't think you're gonna be a good reputation, but.
You wouldn't have a good reputation, but you'd be known.
Oh yeah, I'd be known as the Shark Week biter.
What does to live every day like it's Shark Week mean to you?
It means being on the prowl.
Live it to your fullest.
Folks, I'm so excited because Shark Week starts tomorrow. I'm hyperventilating. I'm too excited. I am. Woo! What am I gonna do tonight?
Jaws is on!
What? Jaws is on? I need another paper bag. Thanks so much for watching. Oh God, at the same time. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Give this one love. Right lung.